Brent, here's the transmission that's been taken apart by Carl. He's our builder here. And what we have, we've laid out the parts, and most of these are the bad ones, and I'll get into that. But what he's done also here is, these are the parts that are good, and these have been cleaned up, and luckily this is good, your pump, and you got tight gears on here, so this is good to go. But here's where the problem is. You can see here, these are clutches, and it's hard to see. These teeth in here wore off, so I know it's difficult for you to see, but they are completely wore down. And this here is a band, and what this does is this band is a, you can see it's a circle here, this is the name implies, a band, and what it does is squeezes down and pulls the gears in, and this is supposed to be brown. As you can see clearly, it's black, so this is just, it's just burned. And this here is pretty interesting. This is completely, you can see this is completely torn up here on these roller bearings, and what's happened is it's caused this, and again, this may be a little difficult to see, but the color there, see how it's shiny on the right and left, and the middle is kind of cloudy? That's the race on here, and this is pitted. It's completely all pitted up, and also, it's right there, so that is just tore up. When we come over here, these are your, this is actually what the clutches squeeze on, or we call them the steels here, and you can see how burnt this is. You can see the hot spot right there clearly, how that's burnt up. And the fluid, because of this, the fluid's been contaminated. It should be a nice bright pink, and what it is a dark brown, and it's been burnt. And what happens with that is the fluid is contaminated, and it gets inside the electrical. This is a solenoid right here, and it contaminated that, and it's bad, so that needs to be replaced also. The torque converter here, this is a sealed unit, Brent, and what happens is because it's sealed, we can't get the fluid out of there. There's no way to get 100% of the fluid out of this thing, and with that being contaminated, we need to replace that also. But what we are going to do to make sure we get all the bad fluid out of your system is we have a hot flush machine that it flushes all the bad fluid out of your transmission's cooling system. And then, of course, we put in 100% synthetic fluid and replace all that. So we flush that out, and I'll show you how that works. And so I'll send this off, and we'll get you taken care of.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be. And this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does, this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now, it's only at about 179 degrees, and it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it, and it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. Shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. This is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. But that's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.